Welcome to another tutor short provided by the Educational Support Services Department of Lehigh Carbon Community College in Snecksville, Pennsylvania, which is just outside of Allentown. These videos review key learnings for the science courses provided here at LTRIC. And please remember that the Educational Support Services Department does provide walk-in tutoring 5 days a week.
Hello and welcome to the Anatomy and Physiology 1 tutor short, Muscles Part 3. We will be discussing about the upper limb, including the brachium, antebrachium, hand, and thumb muscles. This is given to you by the tutors Kim Rylander and Laura Heck. This will be the group of muscles we will be focusing on this model. Here we can see the biceps brachii. The biceps brachii has two heads, the short or medial head located here, and the long lateral head here. The short medial head originates from the coracoid process of the scapula. The long lateral head originates from the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula. They both insert at the radial tuberosity. The action is to flex and supinate the forearm. Above the biceps brachii is the coracobrachialis, located here. In the next slide, we will remove the biceps brachii to get a better look. Here is our coracobrachialis. The origin is the coracoid process of the scapula, and the insertion is the medial surface of the humerus. The action is the flexion and adduction of humerus. Here we can see the brachialis. The origin is the lower half of the humerus and inserts to the coronoid process of the ulna. The action is to flex the forearm. This is the lateral view of the brachium. Here we can see the biceps brachii, the brachialis, and part of the triceps brachii. The triceps brachii has three heads. The long head originates from the scapula. The lateral head originates from the posterior surface of the humerus, and the medial head originates from the posterior surface of the humerus. They all insert to the olecranon process of the ulna, located down here. The action is to extend the forearm. This is another model viewing the same upper limb muscles. Starting with the first muscle of subscapularis located here, the origin is the subscapular fossa. The insertion is the lesser tubercle of the humerus. The action is to medially rotate the humerus and hold the head of the humerus in the glenoid cavity. Here we see the coracoid brachialis, biceps brachii, and part of the triceps brachii underneath. We have rotated the model so that we can see the lateral side. Here we can see the deltoid, the biceps brachii, the brachialis, and the triceps brachii. Here we can also see a part of the brachioradialis. We have rotated again the model so that you could see the posterior view. Here you can get a better view of the triceps brachii, the deltoid, part of the teres major, brachialis, and a small part of the biceps brachii. Moving on to the antebrachium, or the forearm, here we start with the brachioradialis. The origin of the brachioradialis is above the lateral epicondyle of the humerus. The insertion is the lateral surface of the radius above the styloid process, located down here. The action is to flex the forearm. Here we can see the pronator teres. The origin is at the medial epicondyle of the humerus, located here. and the insertion is the middle lateral surface of the radius. The action is to pronate the forearm. Next to the brachioradialis is the flexor carpi radialis. This muscle originates from the medial epicondyle of the humerus and inserts to the second and third metacarpals. The action is to flex the wrist, assist in pronating, and abducting the hand. Next to the flexor carpi radialis is the palmaris longus, located here. We can see that this muscle stops at the palm. The origin is the medial epicondyle of the humerus. The insertion is the palmar aponeurosis. The action is to flex the wrist. We can see a little part of the flexor carpi ulnaris, located here. This muscle originates from the medial epicondyle of the humerus and the olecranon process of the ulna, and inserts to the pisiform, hamate, and the fifth metacarpal. The action is to flex the wrist and assist in adducting the hand. We can see how the flexor carpi radialis, flexor carpi ulnaris, palmaris longus, and the pronator teres all originate from the medial epicondyle of the humerus. In this model, we have taken off the flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, and the pronator teres to expose the flexor digitorum superficialis. The origin of this muscle is the humerus, ulna, and radius. The insertion is the middle phalanges of digits 2 to 5. The action is to flex the middle and proximal phalanges of digits 2 through 5. We have rotated the model so that we could see the posterior muscles of the forearm. Here along the pinky side is my flexor carpi ulnaris. Next to that is our extensor carpi ulnaris, located here. The extensor carpi ulnaris has an origin at the lateral epicondyle of the humerus and inserts to the fifth metacarpal, and the action is to extend the wrist. Next to the extensor carpi ulnaris is our extensor digitorum, located here. Its origin is also the lateral epicondyle of the humerus. The insertion is the proximal and middle phalanges of digits 2 to 5. The action is extension of those digits 2 through 5. We have rotated the model again to expose now the extensor carpi radialis longus and the extensor carpi radialis brevis. We have almost come to a complete full circle on the forearm, as we can see now that we are getting closer to the biceps brachii and leaving the triceps brachii. Here we see the extensor carpi radialis brevis. Its origin is the humerus, and the insertion is the third metacarpal. The action is to extend the wrist and abduct the hand. Above that, we see the extensor carpi radialis longus, located here. The origin is also the humerus, and the insertion is the second metacarpal. The action is to extend the wrist and abduct the hand. We also see the view of the brachioradialis, located here. Now we're going to take a look at the muscles that extend and abduct the thumb. Here we see the extensor pollicis longus, but we only see the tendon. The origin is the ulna and radius. The insertion is the distal phalanx of the thumb. The action is to extend the thumb. Next, we see the extensor pollicis brevis, located here. The origin is the radius. The insertion is the proximal phalanx of the thumb. The action is to extend the thumb. Next, we see the abductor pollicis longus, located here. The origin is the interosseous membrane. The insertion is the trapezium and the first metacarpal. The action is to abduct the thumb. Here we see the abductor pollicis brevis. The origin is the tubercles of the scaphoid and the trapezium. The insertion is the proximal phalanx of the thumb. The action is to abduct the thumb. Here we see the flexor pollicis longus, only the tendon though, located here. The origin is the radius, ulna, interosseous membrane. The insertion is the distal phalanx 1. The action is to flex the thumb. We can also see a better view of the abductor pollicis brevis, located here. Thank you for watching. To view any of the models, or if you have any questions, please come to the Science Lab in SH 150 in the Educational Support Services Center. Thank you.